Brothers and sisters, we say to you in the first khutbah of Shawwal that one of the blessed period is over, that is Ramadan. Then we enter from the following day to another period of which is period of blessing, Mubarak, that is period of Hajj. In fact, Shawwal, Dhul Qa'dah, Dhul Hajjah, these 3 months are the months of Hajj. We have to prepare ourselves to go to Hajj during this period, journey, before journey, the preparation, all these are very important tasks. The Hajj, around a house, which is a blessed house, which is the most important house of Allah in this planet. He has allowed to build the house first in this world to worship Him, that is in Mecca, that is the Baytullah al-Haram in Mecca al-Mukarramah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made this Hajj of this house is fard, one of the pillars of Islam. And it is a huge ibadah. Several days need to be devoted for one ibadah to complete. Huge kind of activities, one place to another. Before that, having a journey from outside of miqat, you're preparing with ihram, all this for this one ibadah. How huge it is. We need to understand where we are going to. In a very blessed land, Al-Baladul Amin, the town of security and peace and safety. Where the house, the first house of Allah is built. And in that whole city, so much ahkam and adab, so much blessed. Praying one rak'ah there is multiplied our reward how many times? 100,000 times. One rak'ah's reward. Not only salah is multiplied this way. All ibadah we do multiplied in huge amount. All zikr of Allah, dua, istighfar, tawbah, tilawatul Quran. If anybody is fasting there as well, all will be hugely multiplied. Similarly, if somebody is busy committing sin over there, then that sin will not stay within that other part of the world. Sin will be reward multiplied many times as well. Sin will be multiplied as well. This is the ulama's ijtihad from the similar, from the same issue of the multiplication of the ibadah. The sins will be also multiplied. We have to be very careful. Many people go, this is something we have to go, we have to witness so many things. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about the Hajj, giving the ahkam of the Hajj, وَأَذِّنْ فِي النَّاسِ بِالْحَجِّ يَأْتُوكَ رِجَالًا وَعَلَى كُلِّ دَامِرٍ يَأْتِينَ مِنْ كُلِّ فَجٍّ عَمِيقٍ. And proclaim to the people the Hajj, they will come to you on foot and on every lean camel. They will come from every distant pass. Allah said to Ibrahim alayhi salam, once he completed the house, give this declaration, announce it. He announced it reached to every corner of this planet. And it is renewed by through our Sharia, the Quran, to us. At that time it was camel or any other animal, but nowadays we don't use camel, aeroplane or any other mode of transport. But we become at least tired. If our vehicle is not tired, we are tired. I know when you land in Jeddah, you're tired already. So, but we do something very important to go there. Why you go there? What is the benefit? لِيَشْهَدُوا مَنَافِعَ لَهُمْ. That they witness benefits from for themselves. So much benefit there. What is the benefit? Fasting the house of Allah, which direction we pray every day, 5 times a day. It is in front of us. We can see it, visualize it in front of us. إِنَّ أَوَّلَ بَيْتٍ وُضِيَ لِلنَّاسِ الَّذِي بِبَكَّةَ مُبَارَكًا وَهُدًى لِلْعَالَمِينَ. Indeed, the first house of worship established for mankind was that at Bakka. Another name of Makkah is Bakka. Blessed. It is a blessed house. And the guidance of the worlds, surely, except the one who is, who is away from Allah's mercy, generally, people will go and will come back with strengthening their iman. Their iman is gone high. They are thinking seriously to leave all the sins, doing more tawbah. They're enlightened by seeing this house of Allah and doing ibadah there. Why? فِيهِ آيَاتٌ بَيِّنَاتٌ مَقَامُ إِبْرَاهِيمُ وَمَنْ دَخَلَهُ كَانَ آمِنًا. In it are clear signs such as the standing place of Ibrahim, and whoever enters it shall be safe. There is a lot of adab and ahkam. Nobody can attack anybody. Nobody can quarrel there. Everybody in peace. All these will show them sign of the deen, of the very sign of Allah there. Zamzam is not a sign of Allah. How many people is drinking for this Zamzam? How many people every time drinking all this bucket of water from their bottles of water? How many people are using one well, providing all this water for all the centuries, never came to end, never came to have a shortage of the water there? Is it not sign of Allah? Should not it increase our iman? Safa, Marwa, sign of Hajj alayhi salatu wasalam. Arafat, Mina, Muzdalifah, people are in this white dress, two pieces of the simple cloth, not wearing any kind of trouser, sherwani, or a suit, coat, nothing. All this must increase people's iman. That's why Allah made it fard upon those who have ability, they should not miss this opportunity. وَلِلَّهِ عَلَى النَّاسِ حِجُّ الْبَيْتِ مَنِ اسْتَطَاعِ إِلَيْهِ سَبِيلًا وَمَنْ كَفَرَ فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ غَنِيٌ عَلِي الْعَالَمِينَ. And due to Allah from the people is Hajj to the house for whoever is able to find thereto a way. But whoever disbelieves, then indeed Allah is free from need of the worlds. It seems if somebody is not going deliberately to Hajj, missing it, as if he's committing kufr, an act of kufr of not performing fard Hajj. That's why Umar radiallahu anhu used to say, those who are dying without performing fard Hajj, let them die as a Christian or Jew or anything else, but not as a Muslim. And he said also, I wish to appoint some of the people with the assignment to list those people who are able to perform Hajj because they are financially, physically able, but they don't do, delay years and years. I would like to have their list. I consider them, probably they are not Muslims. So important it is that we do fard Hajj, don't delay. If it's fard upon you, don't say after 3 years, 5 years, 10 years, I'll be doing it. Who has given you guarantee? One of the hadith Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, oh people, if Hajj is fard upon you, don't delay, rush, hurry up. You don't know what will happen to you next year. You may fall ill, totally disabled. You may fall, you may die. You don't know who has given you guarantee. So if you didn't plan, please look if there is last chance available, any seat available to book for you this year. If not, you should have a clear firm intention to do next year. But we go there with preparation. All this mental preparation, spiritual preparation, leaving all this sin, giving up from the sin, and getting a niyyah to Allah to get al-hajj al-mabrur, the hajj al-mabrur, how it happens. That reward is only Jannah. I should come with Jannah. I shouldn't miss it over there. And I should come with, like, yawmi raja, waladatu ummuhu. The day he came back from the Hajj, he came with wiping out all the sin, forgiven all of the sins. He, like a newborn baby comes to this world, he's coming to his place, with all sins are forgiven. With all this niyyah, with all this plan, we must go, we must do, not in a holiday mood. You'll see many people go to Umrah, mashallah, very good. Our people don't go to, mashallah, holiday in moon places. Rather, many people prefer that instead of holiday, they'll go to Umrah, Hajj, Mecca, Medina, very good idea. But don't go with holiday mood. Go with the ibadah mood. Even in Hajj time you go, in Umrah time you go, there is many people will not consider the hijab is something important, even over there. It's like holiday. Even especially in Hajj time, when they are in ihram, maybe a little bit of control. Once the 10th day of the Hijjah or 11th day, they take off the ihram, put on the normal dress, again you see the holiday mood is started over there. Subhanallah. People don't know what these places are. You are there to secure your Jannah. You are there to be forgiven all of your sins. And you don't care all this. Your mind is something, you know, else than getting all this ni'mah. That we need to secure, that we are really motivated. We are really spiritually in a very high level. All this needed reading, studying, preparing ourselves. We must, good kind of Hajj ta'aleem. What is taking place? Inshallah, our Hajj ta'aleem date will be announced very, inshallah, after khutbah. You must come and inform others to attend. And we must know also that two of the important lessons we learn in the Hajj. One is Tawheed of Allah. Tawheed of Allah, the declaration from very Talbiya, oneness of Allah, is very emphasized again and again in Talbiya. And that is Labbaik Allahumma Labbaik, Labbaik la sharika laka Labbaik, Innal hamda wa ni'mata laka wal mulk la sharika lak. Here I am, O Allah, in response to your call. Here I am. Here I am, you have no partner. Here I am. Indeed, all praise, grace, and sovereignty belong to you. You have no partner. This is the slogan of Tawheed in the Hajj. If we our aqidah is polluted with shirk, with bidah, and we go there, we don't follow sunnah, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, khudu anni manasikakum, take from me your rites of Hajj and Umrah. You must follow him in the Hajj and Umrah. Not only in Hajj and Umrah, we follow him in every aspect of the life. This mahabba of Tawheed, love of Tawheed and Sunnah, this very carefulness from the all kind of shirk and bid'ah, which is opposite to Sunnah, we must take it seriously. So we purify our aqidah, our belief, our faith from shirk. We take pure Tawheed and we follow sincerely Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam in ibadah, in Hajj, in salah, in fasting, in the walima, in the wedding, in business, in every relationship between us and between Allah, everywhere we have to follow Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, role model of us. That's two of the important message we should carry always. That's why Tawheed is starting of the Hajj, and everywhere takbir in the ayyam tashriq, and also two of the surah we need to recite, recommended in the sunnah. After tawaf, you pray two rakah, salatu tawaf. Then the recommended surah is Qul ya ayyuhal kafirun and Qul huwa Allahu ahad. Both this surah is dealing with the pureness of the tawheed, with the pure tawheed. That is very clearly evident. So with all these, if we perform the Hajj and Umrah, inshallah, we hope to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that our Hajj and Umrah will purify us. All will be making our sins are away. That's why it came in hadith. تابعوا بين الحج والعمرة فإنهما ينفي عن الفقر والذنوب كما ينفي الكير خبث الحديد والذهب والفضة وليس للحجة مبرورة ثواب إلى الجنة. Oh people, continue, do after one another if you have time, tawfiq and ability, even more than one hajj, more than one umrah. Time to time going again. This to Hajj and Umrah removes from you poverty and sins the way blacksmith moves all this rust of the metal things through the fire, through burning it. The same way Hajj and Umrah will clean you from all kind of sins. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq. Those who are going for Hajj, Hajj and Mabrura, Wasayya Mashkura, Udhamban Mabfura. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين من كل ذنب فاستغفروا واتوبوا إليه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم.